In this video, I'm going to talk about power. Particularly, I'm going to talk about power in a resistor. We're going to use Ohm's law to derive the relationship between power, voltage, and current in a resistor. Let's also distinguish power consumed from power supplied in the context of a very simple circuit. So let's draw one circuit. We'll assume that we have a DC voltage source connected to a single resistor. Through that resistor flows a current I. We know from Ohm's law that V equals IR. The power law in a resistor tells us that the power consumed is related to IV. And for a DC voltage source, the same equation tells us the power supplied. And it's very important to remember that there's a distinction between the two. Although the same equation, P equals IV, works for both the source and the load, they mean two very different things. Because if I write P equals IV for the voltage source, that means that the voltage source supplies this much power. But if I write P equals IV for the resistor, it means this is the amount of power that the resistor consumes. It's the amount of power that the resistor burns up. Because we have conservation of power. Every watt that the DC voltage source supplies has to be consumed by the resistor. Otherwise, it violates conservation of energy. And power is just energy per unit time. From Ohm's law, we can modify the power rule just a little bit. So from P equals IV, we can substitute for V IR, and we end up with I squared R. So this is an equation that tells us the amount of power that's consumed in a resistor if we know the current. P equals I squared R. We can also make a substitution for I. We know that current is V over R in a resistor. Therefore, we know that the power consumed in a resistor is V squared over R. In both cases, the power supplied by the voltage source is equal to the power consumed by a resistor. In a more complicated circuit, for example, we could have two resistors. For each resistor, we have the same relationship. Let me label this P sub 1. So P sub 1 refers to the power consumed by resistor R1. Where does the power go? Where does the energy go? For a resistor, the energy ends up all getting converted into heat. So if you hook a battery up to a resistor, then every watt supplied by that battery heats up the resistor. This is like an electrical stove, an electrical burner, or a dryer. It's just a resistor, so every watt that you supply, it gets converted directly to heat. For the second resistor, since we have the same current flowing, and I've labeled it just I, the power consumed is I squared R sub 2. Now, if I ask the question, what is the power supplied by the DC power supply in this case, it's a sum of the two, because we have to have conservation of power. If you enjoyed watching this video, then you might be interested in following our playlist and learning more about the fundamentals of electrical circuits.